Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I will continue with a topic that I started some weeks ago when I start to describe the different ML AI service that we had available in the different cloud providers. And I create a couple of videos about how to work with Google Vertex AI and how to work with the new models that Google released past December last year, no? The Gemini series, and well, we had an introductory video how to set up the environment, how to access the Google Cloud and activate the API, and also access the API via the Python SDK, and also we create some examples using and some prompting using the language models that we had available in Vertex AI. So today we are going to look at the multimodal prompts, and I will give you some examples of what is capable of Gemini. It is quite impressive, especially with the new version that they released recently, the Gemini Pro 1.5. It's still in preview, but you will see that it's quite impressive what is able to do this model, especially when these capabilities that the model had to combine different unstructured data like video, audio, text in different formats, and be able to extract the relevant information from this unstructured data and provide concise and correct answers about to the questions that you may formulate. You will see this now a little bit in some examples I prepared for you. So I assume that you had access to Google Cloud and you had your account set up, the API activated. I explained how to do this in the previous videos I did about Vertex AI, and today this we will not cover it. In any case, if you need some support, just let me know. I will try to create it, because I think that is, if you are not familiar with Google, could be a little bit overwhelming at the beginning, especially set up the service account to access to the service, to access to the APIs from your local environment. But well, today in this video we will not cover it. We will just focus on the multimodal models and how to do completions. We will not cover today as well chat. I will prepare a second video for that. I will just cover completions, prompting, multimodal prompting with the different types of the unstructured data that is able to ingest and use Gemini 1.5 Pro. So it's still, as I said, in preview, but I just waiting today release this to production, because really it's a very big step forward. And well, the model, as they described, is has a context window of 200,000 tokens, which is really big, similar to what provide by default Claude 3. And they are working, for what I read as well, that they are working in a model in the next release. It will have 1 million tokens, saying that the highest class of the Claude 3 with 1 million tokens as context windows, which will allow us to, well, to do a lot of things, really. it's huge, very huge context windows, and then we can ingest many data with that, no? Okay. To work with the SDK, the only thing that you need is to install this in local, this library, Google Cloud A platform. And also, you need to have the gcloud, the command line interface of the Google Cloud, install it and configure it in your machine. Again, I explained this on the initial introductory video. I will pass later on some links to those videos if you want to cover them, because you are new to the channel and you didn't watch them. Take a look to them before and set up your environment, and well, once you have it, install the library and log in into the cloud. That way you will be able to use the Python SDK or Node or JavaScript if you prefer other languages, or even you can send requests to the API via HTTP requests or HTTPS in this case. So we install the library, you just need to configure the command line interface, the Google Cloud command line interface, and once you do the logins, is make a cache, create some files with credential in your local profile, and you will not need to log again, unless that you change something on your profile. You will not need to do it again. So you install, you import the necessary libraries. Here we just had the project and the region, my project in Google Cloud, and the region where I had the account. We use the Gemini 1.5 Pro. We pass the prompt. The prompt is a composition of text and a Base64 context. So everything that we send to Gemini in a multimodal prompt, it had to be nominated with a mind type. I will show you this now, and also it had to be transformed to Base64. For those, we transform the content from binary to B64, and then we transfer over the network this content to the API, and in the API they reverse the Base64 and they use the binary content to use it as a input in your prompt. Configuration for the generative model, the number of tokens we can provide, a maximum, o sea, as output 9192 tokens. Temperature, top speed, top cake, normal parameters in generative AI. So, with more safety settings, we talk about this. By default, we need to so the new models in generative AI, in Vertex AI, they had some protections in order to avoid that the models, the response that provide the model contains categories like hate speech, content, dangerous content, sexual explicit or harassment. So we keep this like default, and then on just provide an stream of words. And then on finally, just we print the response that the model provide, and we just return the complete response just to check the tokens. Well, first of all, we are gonna take a book. It's some GPGs from a book I had from my son, and you will see now, so there is some small pictures, and then I asked the model to describe the image. There is 6 images I will show you. They had some text in Russian or Ukrainian, and I asked the model to describe the image Translate to English and translate to Spanish, because I also recorded this video in Spanish. And you see here, there is some of them is difficult to, because there is many words that overlaps in both languages, in Russian and Ukrainian. This, for example, is Ukrainian. You can differentiate Ukrainian from Russian. Just if you contain a Latin I, this is Ukrainian. This is Ukrainian as well. This can be Russian or Ukrainian. And this can be only Ukrainian. So I pass these 6 images to the model. I create a prompt, describe this picture. So I'm just creating a loop. I put on a list every image. Okay? I open it, I read it in binary. I encode the content in Base64, and I create this object. You need to import this part from the library. You just create an object with the adequate mind type. This mind type is for GPG or JPEG, and we add the image or the object. This is an object of the class part in Google. Generative model, preview generative models. Hot up soon is on the final library. And we had, after reading the 6 images, a list of the content in Base64 with some metadata that indicates which type of content we are sending. Now we create a question, a prompt, and then we generate the. We send this to the model. You see here we are just concatenating the question plus the list of objects, which can be whatever. I prepare this just to receive whatever you send. It's gonna be attached in a list of objects. You can set one of many. It doesn't really matter. You just need to be careful that you don't send too much tokens. I try with some large files, bigger than 10 megabytes. It will tell you that they don't accept it. So at the moment, probably there is some limitations. I'm not 100% sure that the limitations are on the model itself, because 200,000 tokens are a lot. There are a lot of tokens, even for 10 megabytes of file. Or probably it's a problem with my quota. I need to investigate this. As soon as I know, I will continue, because I'm preparing a. This is all this prompt is few shot. Sorry, is zero shot prompting. We don't provide any example. I was preparing as well a few shot prompting with multimodal and multimodal example with few shot. And the model overflow, and then it didn't give me any answer. And again, I received some strange message that either I don't have quota, or simply I overflow the window context. I don't really know. I need to investigate this. I will try to do a second video with few soft prompting, but you will see here that somehow it's not really necessary, no? Okay, so here the first example is a prompt. I will extract the text for images. This is doing OCR simply. Describe every image and translate language. No, I will translate to English and to Spanish. So I take the Russian, extract it from Russian or Ukrainian. In fact, everything is Ukrainian, but well, it can be sometimes understood as Russian. But yeah, I take the content. Let me put that one and send it to the model. It's taking some seconds after the model responds, and you can see here. Yeah, let's check the content. Let me check this. So, oops, why we had this open here? Okay. So the first image is Saki, Prodocci, Prodolci, Yadi. Yeah, continue the rows. Translation to Spanish is also correct. He identified to Russian. It can be as well. Rakati Miacik. Also correct. He's understood like Russian. Roll the ball is correct. Now the third. The third is Grom, because this is Ukrainian. Definitely the A, no, I, Latin I is not existing in Russian language. So this is Grom, but in any case, the translation is correct. He shot the arrow. Now, and also you can check the descriptions. They are quite precise. B24. Domaliots. Yeah, that is Ukrainian, correct. Oops, I lost the image. This is Ukrainian because we had this eye there. Finish the snails. Termina en dejar los caracoles. Is correct as well. Next image. Correct. Dochik. Yeah. It can be Russian. It can be Russian as well. But where he identify as Ukrainian. In fact, all the images are in Ukrainian. But well, as I said, some of the characters overlap with the Russian language, so it had the same printing writing in both languages. So the only way to identify is when there is a character that doesn't exist. All the characters that exist in Russian exist in Ukrainian, but not vice versa. So, for example, this I with two dots doesn't exist in Russian, but all the letters that you see here exist in both languages. Find the triangles and encuentra los and etc. So, correct. I don't know what you think, but to me, this is really impressive. The model make OCR, extract the text in the correct language, and also translate it correctly to English and translate it correctly to Spanish in this case. So a small error here, but well, this is really not. Probably many of us are not able to do it like the model is doing it. Okay, let's move to the second example. We take a video. It's a small video about Shrek. Yeah. This is for this movie. And I just will pass after the video all the content later to the repository. You can play around in your environment. So here I read the video. The format in mind now is video MP4, and just I ask the model to create a history from this video for a child of 5 years. Yes, and then you will see here. That the model is doing really good job. It's taking a while. Content is a little bit, yeah. Check later. You can change as well the parameters of the model, increasing the temperature to make it more creative, and increasing top P, top K. Yeah, you make it some different samples. Remember that we had a temperature 0.4. Well, medium small creativity, and then only the response we have here. So the number of tokens we spend 1,265. Now we take another file. This is an audio file. Let me show you. I don't know if you will be able to hear. It's not is a
But what if
conversation.
somebody decides to break it? Be careful that you keep adequate coverage, but look for places to save money. Maybe it's taking
In
longer
between
to get
2 months,
things squared
in
away than the
English,
bankers
well,
expected.
check it out later. I will upload this to the repo. So I open the content. Here is audio WAP. And yes, I asked to transcribe the literally the content of the audio, and then on later also to translate to Spanish. You later on can read it. The transcription is completely precise, and then on we can do the same and translate to Spanish. You may ask why to translate to Spanish, because I'm Spanish and it's easy for me to understand if the model is translating correctly. And yeah, it's translating to break it. Yeah, it's good translation. And the fourth one is taking a report of something I did years ago. Probably 8 years ago, about forecasting, time series forecasting. It's just something I did for a project. Yeah, I'm speaking about forecasting time series, about stationary, trend, seasonality, stationary, etc., moving average, and doing some decomposition of signals, ARIMA. Well, probably some of you know this stuff. Yeah, it's very interesting stuff as well. And then I just ask to the model to extract from, this is a PDF, and then we change the mind type here. And we just ask the model to extract the content, the main facts, and make a summary. And then exactly how to check stationarity. This word is impossible for me to sometimes pronounce. And then on, you can see here, you can later on, I will pass you as well the document, and you can check that is quite precise. This document, thank you. Thank you very much, model. These are not the right. Yeah. Okay, that's all. I think it's really impressive what the model is capable of. It's a big step forward if you check the previous videos I did, I was using Gemini 1.0 and Gemini Pro 1.0. I was a little bit disappointed. I made these videos a couple of months ago, or 3 months ago, when after releasing the Google the Gemini, a couple of months after, we were using at that time the Gemini Studio, and then the outcomes were a little bit disappointed. But now, with the release of the 1.5 is, well, they make a big improvement, really big improvement. It's something that to take into account when you are working with this kind of data, which it's gonna make a very big improvement with handling this data. It's really impressive. Well, I have no words. So that's all. I hope you like it. If you like it, just give me a like. Subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. And if you consider, you can even share the video with some friends, just to show what Gemini is capable of. Thank you very much for watching, and see you soon.